Thank you, Eric Sped, for your kind invitation. I have the great honor to speak about SWEPS or CTA for PCV diagnosis and neurovascular activity evaluation. We should say now aneurysmal type 1 new vessels, but I still speak of PCV in my paper. So we have seen that OCTA brings a great contribution in AMD for the CNV detection and evaluation of activity, but OCTA seems less accurate for the evaluation of PCV. The purpose of our study was to determine PCV diagnosis and neurovascular activity evaluation agreement between SWEPS source OCT evaluation and multimodal imaging with fluorescein angiogram, endothelin in green, and OCT B-scan evaluation. It was quite a challenge to guess if we were before PCV just looking at SWEPS or CTA. And we tried to find out some biomarkers of PCV, thanks to OCTA, and check if OCTA COSCAS criteria used for AMD, CNV, are relevant or not for the evaluation of the activity of the branching vascular network. We examine patients with active or non-active exudative AMD and PCV, and they underwent SWEPS or CTA with the Triton SWEPS or CT. And the diagnosis and the neurovascular activity of the patients were assessed using multimodal imaging by a confirmed examinator. And the SWEPS or CTA were analyzed by an expert operator blind for the other images to diagnose whether patients had PCV or AMD and to evaluate their neurovascular activity. The branching vascular network criteria activity were determined according to COSCAS criteria and with COSCAS criteria an active CNV with a dense branching pattern, wheel shape, anastomosis and loops. Here, a quiescent CNV with loose branching pattern, long and filamentous shape, no loops. And sometimes it's very difficult to evaluate the activity of this kind of CNV with a loose branching pattern. But when we see the color photograph, it's an active CNV. The PCV diagnosis was based on TAN classification. It described three types of PCV. Type 1, it's idiopathic PCV with the interconnecting channel on ICGA. Type B, with a branching vascular network with no leakage on fluorescein angiogram. And type C, with a branching vascular network with a late leakage on fluorescein angiogram. And the diagnosis and activity criteria of PCV with the SWEPS or CTA, we used a 50 micron slab to analyze the choriocapillaries, the Brooks RPE layers, the RPE outer retina layers, to analyze the two principal items, the branching vascular network, which was or dense, very dense, with a kind of booth shape aspect, loose as a dead tree shape, and if he had pseudopod-like and anastomosis. And the polyps were described as black holes with hypo or hyper signal and surrounded or not with halos. The result in the patient, we had 13 patients with AMD and 14 with PCV, 10 active PCV and 4 inactive PCV. Mean age was, the patients were older in AMD as usual, and the sex was predominant female in AMD and male in PCV. Most of our patients were Caucasian. with Swepp Source Society, AMD was diagnosed in all the patients. PCV was diagnosed only in 71.4% of the cases. The PCV choroidal thickness was over more than 200 microns. All the polyps were located above the Bruch's membrane, and two polyps had halos. The branching vascular network, loose branching vascular network, all the branching were located between the RPE and the Bruch's membrane. Half was loose branching vascular network. In this loose branching vascular network, there were six active PCV and one inactive PCV. When we had dense branching vascular network, there were four active PCV and three inactive PCV. Here, it's an active PCV with a loose branching vascular network. For the activity evaluation, there were 92% of co-occurrence among AMD and only 61.5% of co-occurrence among PCV patients. For the misdiagnosis, it was one inactive AMD was confounded with one active AMD, three inactive PCV with three inactive AMD. One active PCV with one active AMD. We are concordant with all the publication in the literature for our results. Here, example of our cases, one inactive AMD confounded with one active AMD. We thought it could be active AMD, and it was inactive AMD without any fluid. Here, one active PCV was confounded with one active AMD because we couldn't detect any polyp. There were no evident correlation between branching vascular network and polyps activity. Here, type A PCV with a very small branching vascular network and polyps represented as black holes. Here, an example of active type B PCV. It's active. No leakage on fluorescein angiogram. Late phase, two polyps, and we can see a loose branching vascular network with an extrusion of the branching with the feeder vessels of an ending with the polyps. And here another case of type B PCV with a mixture of dense here and loose branching vascular network. And ICG here, and the branching is ending by polyps, but the polyps is not very, very well seen. Here, active type C PCV with a leakage on fluorescein angiogram late phase. We can see an aspect of bush shape OCTA. Of the branching vascular network, and an extrusion from the branching vascular network ending by a polyps. Here, another case of active type C PCV with the leakage on fluorescein angiogram of the branching vascular network, and here again, this aspect of bush shape branching vascular network ending with an extrusion ending by a polyp and a halo around the polyp. Here another case with active type C PCV with a the same. The branching vascular network is quite dense. There is a kind of feeder vessels extruding from the branching, ending by a polyp or kind of anastomosis. Here, so we often saw this aspect of branching vascular network with a kind of pseudopod extruding from the branching, and we had this kind of extrusion from the branching vascular network. Oh yes, thank you. And this kind of feeder vessels or anastomosis, and then the polyps. So I think it's important to know that there is a big learning curve to assess, understanding what we are seeing. There is a very high quality of the swept source OCTA images for the PCV detection. The pseudopod-like extrusions may represent a risk of recurrences. Bush shape of branching vascular network in our small study was always associated with an active type C PCV, and loose branching vascular network was not necessarily a sign of inactivity of the PCV. These results demonstrate that COSCAS CNV activity criteria grid on OCTA is applicable to PCV eyes only in active type C PCV. Currently, OCTA alone is not able to diagnose efficiently PCV activity, and we still need ICG. Thank you.